On April 6, 1970, photojournalist Sean Flynn, along with friend and colleague, CBS cameraman Dana Stone, went missing in action after being captured at a communist-held roadblock in Cambodia. Just one of a million tragic tales of the Indochina conflict. But Sean Flynn was someone exceptional. He was the son of Captain Blood, Hollywood swashbuckler Errol Flynn. But more importantly, he was Sean Flynn. After 40 years of unsuccessful attempts of recovery by the United States government and private individuals, his next of kin, Sister Rory Flynn, decided to launch one final attempt to bring him home. The following film documents the mission, codenamed
I think your journey is a quixotic one. By that I mean you've chosen a very specific route. Sometimes the odds are stacked against you.
Oh, bullshit, man. The guy knows it's the correct fucking information, man. He knows for sure it's the correct information, man. It's been corroborated by the fucking Khmer Rouge guys out there, man.
No shooting, no film. With flash, girl, child
in the dark. Death Riders of Body Hunters. Now we've had a major, major situation. Right now we're riding with three members of the what appears to be Vietnamese and composite with the Cambodian military. We have no idea exactly where we're going.
Who'll pay reparations on my soul?
They better fucking shoot me to stop me, okay?
For every setback, there's a breakthrough.
But I think that it's because Sean wants to come home today. That's the only reason why. I think he's guiding us.
Documents written, many directions for the aid that was given. They gave us pieces of silver and pieces of gold. Tell me who paid reparations on my soul.
He specified that specific cashew tree, but I'm sure after 40 years of faded memory, rice wine, probably got hit in the head with a pickaxe during the 80s, you know. It could be any one of these cashew trees. And
be that as it may, if I'm wrong, I'm wrong. I don't know that the United States government is interested in all these cases because there's so many people out there looking for POWs still. And I think that's it's scenery. It diverts from the larger issue. I mean, to look for POWs in the Vietnam War is to divert the memory from the great damage done by the war. And it's got a Rambo effect, Rambo being an American superhero who goes to Asia to find POWs out.
ចេះបានប្រហែល3-4 ថ្ងៃយូរមកប្រហែលកន្លះខែគាត់នៅក្រុមផ្ទះអ៊ំខ្ញុំហ្នឹងប៉ិនអត់ដឹងថាយកពីណាមកអត់ដឹងហ្នឹងដឹងថាឃើញនៅក្នុងហ្នឹងថាឃើញគេយកទៅចងហ្នឹងយាមគេនៅយាមហ្នឹងចឹងបាទហើយគេស្លាប់ហ្នឹងគេស្លាប់ដោយសារអីដែរគេស្លាប់ដោយសារកំភ្លើងប៉ុន្តែបាញ់អត់កើតបាញ់អត់ខិតចឹងបាទលេង
think it's a reactionary position, and I'd be careful where you spend your energy. If you're progressive, be progressive about it. Go for things that you really can solve and help and do. That's my advice.